In this video, we will see how to control the various voltage magnitudes using tap changing transformers. Now, let us see a typical or a very easy power system in which I am having tap changing transformers at the both ends of a transmission line, and the transmission line is shown through an equivalent impedance Z. So, let us say this is a transmission line with an impedance Z, and it is having tap changing transformers at its both ends. Let us say this is the sending end and the voltage is Vs, the current is Is, the tap changing transformer is having an off nominal tap ratio to be 1:Ts, and this transformer is having off nominal tap ratio as Tr:1, and here I will write that this is voltage Vr and the current into the load is Ir. Okay, now because of these two tap changing transformers, voltage here will be different. Let us say it is Vs prime and the current, let us say it is Is prime. Similarly, the voltage here will be, let us say, Vr prime, and the current here is Ir prime. Now, before deriving a relation between the tap setting and the various voltage levels and the power delivered to the load, we should know that for any network which is shown through an impedance, let us say equivalent impedance Z, which is having a current I through it, let us say current is Ir through it, then the voltage drop across this, let us say this is Vs and this is Vr, then the magnitude of voltage drop across this element can be approximately written as Ir r cos phi plus Ir x sin phi, where this Z is nothing but r plus jx and the phi is nothing but the power factor angle of the current with respect to, let us say, this is the reference voltage. Here all these terms are in magnitude form. If you want to see how this relation is derived, you should refer to my lecture number 63. That is, refer lecture number 63. This is a very simple but an important result which we will see many times. Even when we will discuss about voltage regulation in a transformer, we will see that this result is there. Okay, so this result is a very important result and very basic result, and it can be easily derived, which I have already done in lecture number 63. Now, I am going to write Vs prime minus Vr prime is equal to delta V, which is nothing but this. Here, I can write Vs prime as nothing but Ts into Vs, and Vr nothing but Tr into Vr. Okay, now this is equal to delta V. Now, the current through this impedance is IR prime. Okay. So, instead of writing IR, I will write IR prime here. Let us say this is current IR prime, IR prime, IR prime. And this is voltage VS prime, VR prime. Okay. So, this delta V can be written as delta V is equal to IR prime R cos phi plus IR prime X sin phi. Okay. Now, if I multiply and divide with VR prime, the right hand side of this equation, what I will get here, when I will take this VR prime inside this bracket, I will get delta V is nothing but VR prime IR prime cos phi into R plus VR prime IR prime sin phi into X divided by VR prime. Now, the complex power or the apparent power delivered to the load is nothing but VR IR in magnitude. Okay. If this transformer is lossless, then it is nothing but equal to VR prime into IR prime. Okay, so this is the apparent power. Now, apparent power into cos phi is nothing but the real power delivered to the load. Okay, so it will become PR plus, similarly, apparent power into sin phi is nothing but the reactive power delivered to the load. So, in this way, I can see that the delta V can be written as PR plus XQ divided by VR prime, where P is the real power delivered to the load and X is the reactive power delivered to the load. Okay. So, putting this in this equation, what I will have? I will have TS VS minus TR VR is equal to, now VR prime can be replaced with TR VR. So, I will write it as RP plus XQ divided by TR VR. Here I have replaced VR prime with TR VR. Now, you see that this delta V is nothing but IZ, okay, or the IR prime Z. Now, let us assume a case in which the load is such that the voltage is sagging or the voltage at the load is low. So, what do we want to do? We want to step up the voltage at this place, okay. So, when we will try to step up, what will happen? This TR will be smaller than 1. So, TR will be smaller than 1 to step the voltage up here. Okay. Now, if TR is smaller than 1, what will happen to the current? Using normal transformer ratio, I can show that the IR prime will be greater than the IR. Okay. So, if I want to, you know, step up the voltage beyond a certain level, then it will imply that the current through this element will be high, which will further cause this delta V to increase. That is, the voltage drop will increase. So, there is a certain limit to which this tap can be given a setting. That is, this tap is having an ultimate limit beyond which it cannot be decreased. And similarly, let us see a case in which if I change this, let us say TR below a very certain value, let us say it is 0.5, is to 1. Okay, similarly, I will try to step up here also. Then let us say I change it to, let us say, 1 is to 1.5. What will happen? It will kind of show that the voltage level Vs prime and Vr prime are significantly different with each other, which will ultimately show that delta V is high. Okay, so to keep the voltage on the both side of the transmission line in, you know, similar magnitudes or similar order, so we put a limit to the value of TS and TR, and similarly to keep this voltage drop in control, because, you know, as we already seen in transmission line characteristics, a higher voltage drop implies a higher reactive power through that line. So there is nothing, no element which is going to deliver reactive power. So it implies somehow the reactive power should be delivered through any other bus, or any generator which is connected through this bus should deliver that reactive power. So higher the voltage drop implies the higher the reactance or reactive power through that line. So there is a certain limit to it. So we want to put a limit that TS into TR is equal to 1. This will ensure two things. One, that the voltage levels at the both sides of the line are in similar magnitude or similar order, and this voltage drop is within certain limit. Okay, so from this I will write TR is nothing but 1 over TS. So I will change the value here. So it will give me TS into VS minus 1 by TS into VR is equal to TS VR RP plus XQ. Okay. Now, taking TS common throughout, what I will have? VS minus 1 by TS squared VR is equal to RP plus XQ divided by VR. Now, what I will do, I will divide through VS. Let us see this equation to simplify further in the next slide. Let us say this is equation A, and I will simplify it further in the next slide because of reduced space here. Let us simplify this equation A here. I will take Vs common. It will be 1 minus 1 over Ts squared Vr over Vs is equal to Rp plus XQ divided by Vs Vr. Okay, it implies 1 by Ts squared is nothing but 1 minus Rp plus XQ over Vs Vr divided by Vr Vs. Okay, it implies Ts can be written as 1 minus Rp plus XQ divided by Vs Vr. Let us say this is equation B. Now from equation B, I can see one more thing. Usually for a transmission line, this R is negligible. So let us say I neglect this. So what does it show? The more the reactive power required from the line, that is more the reactive power required by the load, this denominator will become low, which will cause TS to rise, which clearly shows that more the reactive power demanded by the load, higher will be the tap setting required here. Similarly, this once this TS is increased, it implies TR will further reduce. But since there is no reactive power supplying element, so we can just shift these values up to a certain limit, usually which is kept within plus minus 20%. Okay, so using the tap changing transformers, I should only keep the voltage levels between this limit. This is quite ultimate maximum limit. Usually many techs show it to be plus minus 15%, and some of the techs also show as plus minus 10%. Okay, but this is the maximum limit. I have seen transformers having a tap setting from minus 15% to 10%. Similarly, there are transformers with maximum plus minus 20%. So this shows that we can control the voltage levels and the reactive power flow through the transmission line using tap changing transformers. However, that can be up to a certain limit. Beyond that, we need some reactive element or the capacitive element if the load is too lagging to provide that reactive power. Since neither the transformer can, no, both these transformers cannot supply reactive power from on their own. They cannot generate reactive power. From somewhere it should be supplied. So in this way, we can control the reactive power flow and the voltage levels using tap changing transformers up to a certain limit. And this is the equation which governs the power from the load and the tap setting with a given voltage at the receiving end and the sending end. So if you find that this lecture is helpful to you, then please share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.